Okay, and then the issue maker in this my car is this oil ring. Because now when we look that piston ring, normally these piston rings should move in this holes, like in that this way. But now this my piston ring, what is this oil ring in here, this is totally stuck and it don't move. And I try to rotate. And in that purpose, this my engine consumes oil. Look, this is full of oil. Then I scratch a little bit this piston, this plastic dirties, they are burnt oil in here. Now when I rotate, I scratch that there are numbers in here and they are full of oil. And this is like burnt oil. And why this oil is in here? Because this my piston ring is stuck. And why this piston ring is stuck? There is reason. I have not replaced regularly my engine's oils, and I don't have replaced my oil filter regularly with every 5 to 7,000 miles or 10,000 kilometers. And then when we look this piston oil ring, there is this small gap in here in that position. I insert my tool in here and I move up. It's quite stuck. We can see that why this is stuck. There is oil inside this black dirty in there. Let's look that when I manage to open that. It's so stuck that now I manage to take this oil ring out, and look, there is the reason why this oil ring is stuck. Look, this is full of black. Compare like this compression ring. This is shiny and this is full of oil, burnt oil. And then I scratch that, and this makes this my oil ring unmovable. And then when I little bit scratch that black thing away, it becomes, and it is so, it is totally full of. And now when I little bit scratch that, there came this little bit shiny, but this is full of, this is so hard, very harsh and rough. It is like sandpaper, that plane. This is in here, this is quite okay, this is smoothly, but this is not unsmoothly. This is like sandpaper. And when we compare, it should be like that, smoothly and shiny and very, very nice surface. But this is the reason why my oil ring is stuck and why my car consumes oil. And then when I take this upper oil ring in here also away, we can see that it is also that inner part, it is burnt oil. And when oil became old, it became like that. It like sandpaper. This area is like sandpaper, full of burnt oil. There is not so much, but when there's burnt oil, it stucks this compression oil ring, because normally now this oil ring moves. And now this oil ring is not stuck, but before of that it was stuck. Now I can even remove that. And also in here, when we look in here, there's this oily, burnt oil in here. Old. This is old oil. And then how I can install then in here those new piston rings. First step is that, I need to clean that piston totally, like sandpaper or this knife, and take all of these black dirties away, because they are bad in that way all, and then my engine runs even better when I scratch this old plastic black stuff away, and there is huge amount, and then I can see even that there is arrow in here in this piston. Okay, and then when I am next planning to install in there new piston rings, before of that I need to take this one of my piston rings in here, and I need to bend that little bit in that way carefully. Do not use protective eyeglasses, because sometimes this can be cracked. This is warning. Now look another direction. But this is Honda's quality. This is quite high quality piston ring. And then when we have this cleaning tool, I move this all ring holes through, and look, there is this black stuff in here. And I need to clean all of these piston rings. This first compression, second, and then this oil ring, look, there is this black stuff. And in that way, and then there is also those old ring holes, look. And for that purpose, I need now some small tool that I can do holes in here. Okay, and then now I have in here this metallic wire, standard wire, and then when I am planning to clean these pistons, those oil incoming and outcoming holes, I need to insert this my ring in here that way and clean also those. And then when we look in here inside, there is this my cable, and there are those small holes in there, and then I insert my this tool in here, and I clean also, and I need to clean all of these holes in here in that way. And then when this all holes are clean, I can continue. And there is also in that another direction. And this is like that how to clean oil ring, those oil holes, what is in here. And in my case, they are really stuck. Unbelievable. That means that I have issue in my oily holes, and old oil has been made that. Oil and bad quality oil. Okay, and that's, remember to replace oils and use high quality oils like Mobil 1 oil. Okay, now I clean this, and then I insert in here those new piston rings next. And soon we continue. Okay, and then when I have cleaned this my piston and all of these holes in here, I can take again clean cotton cloth, and I clean this my piston totally, also this upper area, and all dirties are bad in engines. And then I can start to install these piston rings, and it happens so that first we need to purchase high quality piston rings. And in like in here, this is Honda's engine, and all of course best piston rings are those originals Honda's piston rings. But then there is aftermarket company from Japan, and name is Nippon Piston Ring. And why I use this ring? The only reason is that this is Toyota's sub company, and Toyota is biggest owner of this company, and it's like Toyota guarantees that these piston rings should be good. And I have purchased these piston rings from this internet shop place, this ebay.com, this US internet e-commerce place, and I can be very sure, about 99.9% sure, that these are original, that they are made in Japan, because this eBay is so trustful company, and there is those informations, and that I use this, and I can use this Nippon piston rings, these piston rings, and there is nice package that is like text that this is like first piston ring, and then there is package that they are in second piston ring, and in this last part is that they are like oil ring in this last part. Okay, and I start this my job so that I take first this oil ring, and this job starts so that I take this oil ring, and this oil ring must be so that this is like this starting point, look, and I insert that in here so that I take piston in my hand, and then I little bit bend that oil ring, and then I move that in here down, and now oil ring is there, and look, this is movable oil ring, and then I take those oil ring, those support things, and they look like that, and look, this is like new, both sides are smooth, and no any hard sandpaper, like in those stuck rings, and then I take this my, I can insert that, I think that in both places are okay, and I insert that in this way, then I move that in down carefully, do not bend too much. And it is now in this second hole, and then a little bit lower, and I insert that in so down, and I keep my hand in that another side, and in this area I can insert that in here, in lower side, look. Then I take this little bit upper, and then I use my screwdriver, but I can lift this easily up in here. In that area we have to be, this is a little bit difficult, but no stress. Now I managed to take that good, and there is this piston ring, and I move it down, and it is, and now I insert that in here, and also that one. And now this lower piston ring is in position. Good. And then I check that, is this my piston ring moving? Good. This oil ring. Okay, excellent. And then I take the second. And now it comes in like this upper area. And let's look that. And I insert first that in here, in this area. And then I carefully, now it went directly, look, now it's in position. And now when I check that is this all parts, and look, now this piston ring is moving, this oil ring. Nice. And then I take this second. Second, there is this text, second piston ring, and this little bit bigger, there is the second piston ring. And I take my piston. Now my target is this like middle hole. And sometimes there is some comment like in, and that means that there is small text in this piston ring that this part goes in, like in my understanding, up. Look, there is small end symbol in here. Can you see? Very difficult to see, but there is some comment, and I insert now in this my ring in that position, and then I start to carefully bend. And be very carefully, because some piston rings can go broken. And it is always in this, I don't bend that too much. This is in this line. And then I rotate that. Same time I check that good, and then carefully I move that down. And now second piston ring is position. Oh, excellent. And then I need this first piston ring. And there is this comment, first piston ring. And I take the piston ring. And I check that is there also comment. Yes, there is small in there. No any comment in here. And this comes like this upper one, and I start in here. First, look, this is the starting point. I check that now it's in position, good, and then now it's in place, look. And then I start to smoothly rotate this, and all time I keep my hand, and note, now it's in there. Okay, and now final step is that this piston ring holes, they can't be in same position. It's good that I rotate that in another direction. There is that hole, and there is that hole. And now I think that my piston rings are ready for installation back in cylinder tubes. And then I check that are my oil ring movable. Yes, it is oil ring, and then piston ring 2 and piston ring 1. It is movable. Okay, excellent. And then we can continue the job, and so easy.